Oh, this is a really exciting day. Because today we're going to start Alan Wake Remastered. And as always, I'm just going to check to make sure that things are working because that, could be important, possibly. I like to do this first and get it out of the way just to make sure that stuff's happening properly. All right, it shows that I'm streaming. And I'm going to just test and see if my microphone's working. Perfect, it's working. Good stuff. I'm just gonna. Oh, ha. Posting it on Facebook might be a thing, even though no one watches it over Facebook. Share, copy. Oh, wait. And if you're watching this in the future, just jump forward about a minute or so, and then we'll get going. But I'm just for those of you who have already joined, I'm just getting things set up right now. I'm gonna watch that in a second, so I keep like skipping it. Cool, getting it onto the Facebook. I'm gonna check Twitter to make sure that worked. Okay. Doop doop Twitter. Sorry. I'll watch that in a second because I do want to see the trailer. Cool. It looks like it posted. We're good to go. We're good to go. So I will watch that. Seems quiet, so that's not the right button. Hold on. There we go. All right, I'm gonna watch this little intro. We may watch it again, but why not? I am so excited to start this. I missed out on it, in 20, I think it was 2010 or 2011 when it first came out. And I remember really wanting to play it, but it just kind of skipped me. I didn't get the chance. And I had the right system. I had the Xbox 360. But I'm excited to spend, the last part of spooky season in the dark with my flashlight. It's like how it was meant to be. That's why I wore the Cthulhu dress again. It's like, what better? What better way to start a psychological thriller than a big noodle gown? And just watching the beginning scene now. It's very quiet. I may have to turn it up again, but we'll see. Hey, Shadow Bullets, you did! I'm sorry for starting so late. I really did start. I was loafing around today, and I had every intention of doing leg day today, and I ended up just dreading it. So I waited a long time. I waited till like 4. Finished up around like 5:30 my workout, and then showered, and I didn't get to eat until like 7, and then get ready until 8. So I'm starting now. Let's start. Let's do it. Right, playing it. New game? Oh, I'm so excited! It's such a spooky atmosphere. It's perfect for right now. What good timing on finishing God of War last week and then starting Alan Wake. Now that we're in a Scorpio season and Halloween season. This is hard. I will pick easy, but if I regret that decision, I can restart.
Stephen King once wrote that nightmares exist outside of logic, and there's little fun to be had in explanations. They're antithetical to the poetry of fear. In a horror story, the victim keeps asking why, but there can be no explanation, and there shouldn't be one. The unanswered mystery is what stays with us the longest, and is what we'll remember in the end. My name is Alan Wake. I'm a writer.
That's a great intro, and Stephen King's right in that respect. That's why he's such a good horror writer, because he doesn't explain shit.
I've always had a vivid imagination, but this dream unsettled me. It was wild and dark and weird, even by my standards. So, yes, it began with a dream. Following a typical nightmare pattern, I was late, desperately trying to reach my destination, a lighthouse. For some urgent reason, I couldn't remember. I'd been driving too fast down a coastal road to get there. I'd seen the hitchhiker too late. He was dead. I was convinced they'd put me in jail and I would never see Alice again.
Oh, he's gone! But the damage to the car is still there.
Suddenly, his body was gone.
Wow, that's cool! Hey, Crutzen!
I was in shock from the crash. I could hardly stand my feet.
Oh, that's so great! I love this. Like, I'm loving the atmosphere so far. Yeah, that's so funny because car is definitely damaged. Look up to the light. R turns the camera. I get it. I'm trying to survey my surroundings. What he said about Stephen King is very, very real. And again, one of the reasons why Stephen King is such a good writer, I noticed that when his characters have like paranormal superpowers, he never explains it. He never goes into it because that's not what is important. It's like the character journeys. So I'm thinking of things like Carrie and stuff like that. Reverse controls for looking up and down. No, I'm good. Oh, I forget. This is the time when people really kind of were like handheld, like assuming that they've never played a game before. Use L to walk, as I understand. Look, I'm walking. What's going on here? Okay. His copies of his books in the trunk. I mean, like, what a way to show that you're guilty of this hit and run. Your trunk is full of Alan Wake novels. Alan! What is this? Is it bricked off?
I'm certain I had just driven from this direction. But now the road was blocked. I had to go to the lighthouse. I knew there was something important waiting for me there.
Okay. All right, I'm going to adjust the sound again. No, that's not the way. I have to press this button. This is a very quiet game, so I'm just going to turn the volume almost uncomfortably high. Yeah, I agree with you, Crutzen. The mystery that you come up with in your head is often way more interesting than what gets revealed. Because, like, you know, it's like the author always has something in mind, but maybe you have something in mind, too. So one of the reasons why I like Dark Souls so much. So, always examine.
The radiator had broken when I hit the hitchhiker. The car wasn't going anywhere.
You gonna, do anything to remove all that evidence, Alan? Look at all this evidence! I know he's trying to do the right thing, but, like, Alan, remove all that evidence. Burn the copies. Get out of there. I'm, like, encouraging him to commit further crimes. All right, so they want us to go to the lighthouse. Let's see. Rain Cove Point. And, I mean, in true Stephen King fashion, this definitely reminds me of New England. I grew up in New England, so, like, all the good Stephen King horror stories take place in, like, Maine. And for good reason! If you've ever driven in Maine at night, it's horrifying! There's, like, and sometimes in the area that I frequent, there's, like, tons of mist. And, like, then deer and animals will come out of the mist. And if you're driving at night, that's terrifying. Truly. Yes, I understand I need to get to the lighthouse. I'm just looking around, friends. Yeah, I'm hyped for Elden Ring 2, Crutzen.
The bridge had collapsed. I'd have to find another way to the lighthouse.
Pick up coffee thermos. Well, at least we got some coffee. Hey! We got a new Taya? Ugh. I'm, like, excited about coffee and trying to convince Alan to commit crimes. What the hell? Alright. Ooh, there's a cool spooky bird! It's a raven! Rain Cove Point Lighthouse. It's a hiking trail. Alright, what's in the dumpster? Is that beer? I was gonna have beer today, but I was like, even at 9, I was still digesting dinner, so I'm like, that's not a good idea. So, for some reason, champagne helps. The cheap variety, which I like. I love cheap champagne. It's awesome. What? Dude! No, shut up!
You don't even recognize me, do you, Ryder? You think you're God?
What the hell? What was I supposed to- What? The darkness that protects the strongest enemies regenerates. Keep that in mind. Oh my God! Hey, Michael, wow! The game has been freaky so far! So good! Oh my, I need to get the fuck! No, no! How do I... How? Oh my god, what? Ah! Go, 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 Alan! No, I do not, sir. Ugh! Oh? Nope, 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 nope. Let's go. No! Okay. So he... You can dodge enemy attack. You can L1 and L to dodge. So he hit someone, but then the body disappeared. And now this, like, shadow man is hunting him. He seemed to suggest that this might have been a dream. He's trying to get to the lighthouse. Shh, fuck. Successful dodges are sometimes highlighted with cinematic moment.
I realized that the hitchhiker was a character from the story I've been working on.
Cool. This is great! Oh my god, this is so spooky! Like, don't act too excited. Anything else? No. They don't want you to explore the level that I'm exploring, but I want to, like, see everything. I'm like, is there a piece of paper on the ground? What does it say? Ah! It opened on its own! This is so spooky, guys! Is there a gas tank? You should grab it, Alan. Gas up your car. This is, like, made at night, though.
Die by the hands of your own flesh.
What?! Hold on, I want to sprint! Let's go, let's go! Ugh! Be the reason why the light bulbs explode when you get under them! This guy knows there's some freaky shit afoot.
Hurry!
Let's go. Oh, this is delightful. Hello, sir.
Clay Stewart, remember? Quickly get inside.
Clay Stewart's got a gun. Can't kill a ghost!
I was trapped. There was no way out.
Oh shit! Look at that!
Die, 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 die.
Oh my god, what the fuck? Oh, this is a lovely cabin though. How do you get out? How do I explore? Oh my god, oh my god. Oh, I can ram things. I'm gonna ram that door. Oh! How do I get out?
Follow the light. You are hurt. You should go into the light. You are already safe there.
Go into the safe haven. Stay in the safe haven until you're completely healed. Okay, so in the light is a safe haven.
Well done. I have something important to tell you. It goes like this. For he did not know that beyond the lake he called home lies a deeper, darker ocean green, where waves are both wilder and more serene. To its ports I've been. To its ports I've been. Do you understand?
No, but that's great!
Follow the light.
Hey, Alice! Oh my god. This is so action-packed so far. Here I was thinking that I would just be walking around with a flashlight. Hold on. Sorry, I think I made it a little too loud and I'm like screaming. Okay. Resume. So beyond the lake that he calls his home is an ocean.
This way, there's no time.
I mean, obviously I like oceanic related horror stories. Oh, yes.
You can't hurt him now. The darkness protects him from all harm. Only light can drive the darkness away and make him vulnerable again.
Okay, the light.
Take the light.
A little slow, friend.
Turn your flashlight toward him and burn the darkness away.
I'm never gonna remember these controls. Ah! He's human now.
No longer protects him, but it's still inside, controlling him. He can't be saved. He's still a threat. He is still your enemy. Here, take the gun.
It's so kind of him to just stick around there and patiently wait for me to shoot him with a gun.
Good. You've done well. Remember what I've taught you. That is all. I will give you back your dream now.
Dude, no, don't go, alien!
A terrible darkness was taking over the world. The lighthouse was the last safe place on Earth.
Hey, Jarvis! I'm jealous of your bagels! Your bagels are delicious looking. Steal all, like, can I just like take this whole cart and like put some wheels on it and just drag it behind me, like, please? Like, why have treasure that you can't drag in large quantities? I'm never gonna remember these controls. This is a problem. Yeah, I am playing this pretty much blind. All I know, I'm getting more ammo! Don't judge me. Don't you dare judge me. But first, steal everything you can see. Yeah, the cookies looked so good too! What herbs did you put on top of those bagels, Jarvis? Jarvis made delicious looking bagels. Good for breakfasts. So get to the lighthouse. Oh! No, ma'am. Ah! Faster! I'm out of batteries! That's not cute! Oh no, are there batteries in here? There better be some batteries. Flare gun! Okay, so switch between weapons and throwables. Maybe the lighthouse is a good place to set the flare. Oh my god. No! Oh, flare gun! Flare gun! Ha ha! Bitch! So you have their three at once, and you're out of batteries. I have... Nope. Checkpoint reached. All right.
I can keep this up.
This is the tutorial. Ah! Get to the lighthouse. Oh, no. He's gonna throw cars at me, that's not cute. Go, go, go. Ah! There we go. Oh no. Oh no, this is... Okay, we're gonna get there. I do not have time to explore, I'm not gonna... Too scared, not gonna do it. We're definitely heading into survival horror territory. Coffee, coffee, coffee. Ooh, gonna throw more cars at me. How rude! I mean, all I got, Michael, is a knife. I'm more of a knife person. Coffee is important, even in the apocalypse.
Easy. Alan, wake up. Shh, baby, just another nightmare. Everything's fine. You dozed off.
Right. Anything more than dozed off would be news for everyone.
Cheer up, handsome. We're here.
Michael, no spoilers if you know things. This is my first time playing. Welcome to Bright Falls. We're on the ferry. This has got to be either New England or like Washington State. The mountains remind me of Washington State. I'm trying to identify this, but he said Stephen King, so I'm like, Maine? Is it Maine? Are we in Maine? Make tummy noises. Okay, yeah.
Let's act like we're on vacation. Go stand next to that old gentleman there. I want a shot of you with the town in the background.
Sure.
Oh, it's Washington?
Title for the shot. A city boy, moments before he got eaten by a bear. Hi.
We saw that man in the beginning.
A good time to visit our town. Deerfest is just 2 weeks away.
Deer Fest, huh? Did you hear that, honey?
You have a lovely wife. If you don't mind me saying, I'm Pat Bane, by the way. Nice to meet you.
The audacity, Pat!
Alan Wake.
I won't pretend I don't recognize a famous writer such as yourself, Mr. Wake. A pleasure. I'm an avid reader myself. I hope this isn't too presumptuous of me, but I'm the night host at the local radio station. Any chance I could get an interview?
Look, Mr. Maine, I'm on vacation. In fact, I'd appreciate it if we could keep my being here just between the two of us. I'm sure you understand.
Fair enough. You can trust me to be this way. Not a hard man to track down if you change your mind, though. I hope you two have a lovely holiday.
Yep, I'm playing on PS4. I know that there's a free PS5 upgrade, though, if you so choose. I know, right? Yoink! He was so rude!
Very nice. I got a couple of really good ones. So you made a friend. That's cute.
Right. Yeah?
Flip phone!
Hey, Miller, how's my favorite writer? Are you there yet?
Barry. Yeah. We just got
it. Are the locals giving you trouble? Just say the word and I'll hop on a plane and come make sure that you're left alone, Al.
No, Barry, we're fine.
Great, great. Just want to make sure you've been relaxed and charmed. So, how is the place? Has it gotten your creative juices flowing?
Barry, we're just settling in.
Okay, Al. I'll call back later to make sure you're doing okay. And you call me if there's a problem, okay? Okay. I'm just looking out for you, buddy. Talk to you later.
I love you too, Barry.
I mean, it doesn't look that bad. Just elderly.
Barry is Barry. I can always turn off the phone.
What did I tell you?
Text message from Barry. He says hi to you too.
Alan's so busy. My plan is to play Ghost of Tsushima after this. That was the original plan to play after God of War, but then this decided to come out and decided to be released like right before my birthday. So I decided to change my plans a bit and then play Alan Wake. Yeah, I've heard great things too. It was free on PS, like, PS Plus a while ago.
You get the full service here.
You may be able to find it on Steam.
I drive the car. I'll even carry the bags. All you have to do is drag your cute butt into the car and enjoy the ride.
Why does she go missing?
Like
I love her.
For husband.
Yeah, but I got a thing for him. Come on, you
Aww.
Bastard.
Come on, you two are so cute. God damn it. Did he go into the wrong car?
Stop at the local diner to get the cabin key from the landlord. A Mr. Carl Stuckey. He's waiting for us.
I love her.
I'll go fill her up while you get the key. I'll pick you up here in, say, 15 minutes?
Sure.
Alan, thank you for coming here with me.
I love you too. Go on. I'll promise to behave. I'd forgotten there were still places like this. Towns where everybody knew everybody.
Welcome to the Oh Dear Diner.
Hi, I was wondering if you could help me. I'm looking for...
Mr. Wake. Alan Wake. Oh, God! I am your biggest fan. I know people say that all the time, but I really am.
I'm glad to hear that.
Rose.
Rose, I'm looking for Mr. Stuckey. Carl Stuckey?
Carl? Of course, Mr. Wake. He must have gone to visit the restroom. He'll be back in a moment.
Oh, my guys, notice something.
I can't believe it. I've got all of your books. I got the cutout from the bookstore when they took it out of the window.
And you keep it here. Well, okay.
Imagine that your favorite author just comes strolling into the diner where you work. That's pretty cool. So we got what looks like the sheriff.
Just don't blame me when you fall in love, because it'll break your heart when you have to leave.
Rusty here is no longer human. Nothing but black coffee under a thin layer of skin.
Yeah,
oh, so he's a park ranger. We're gonna get to know him, I'm sure. I mean, that's a good thing, Michael. It's part God of War and part Bloodborne. That sounds like an ideal situation. Don't threaten me with a good time. I feel like that'd be pretty cool. But she doesn't love fan work, so.
I could really use a tune right now. Coconut, number 6 in the jukebox. I'd do it myself, but both of my legs have gone to sleep. Bad situation.
I would pick some other track just to fuck with this guy.
Serious?
Yes. I'm just stealing every thermos. Hello, sir. Are you waiting? Or lady?
There, young man. You can hurt yourself in the dark.
I think I can handle it, ma'am.
I didn't want to wait. I wanted to find Stuckey, to get the key and get out as soon as possible. The waitress was giving me a headache. Overeager fans always did.
I mean, they're excited to see you, Alan. Let's go to the women's room. I love mystery games, so this is gonna be fun. That beginning was scary, but I was, like, super into it.
Hello? Mr. Stuckey?
Carl couldn't make it. Unfortunately, he was taken ill. But I have the key for you and instructions on how to get to the lake.
Okay.
I wish you a good stay in my cabin. I'll come by later to check how you've settled in. And to meet your wife. I insist.
Thanks.
I mean, now it's misery vibes. Now that we've met, like, the Kathy Bates lady.
Cauldron Lake is a special place. Very inspiring.
The old widow. She's probably the most feared widow in town. Or she's a ghost.
Lucky this time, young man. You can hurt yourself in the dark. This really ought to be fixed, and then I must remind you.
Even that sounds better than your singing.
Are you all right?
Splendid, splendid! Damn hernia. It swells up like a balloon if I lift anything.
Oh, ow! This poor guy.
Splendid, splendid.
The Andersons, they're, local musicians. We're waiting for Dr. Hartman to come pick them up. They wandered off from his clinic at the Cauldron Lake Lodge.
Remind me of who Francis is, because I saw Coven, but that was like a couple years ago. Let's get the fuck... Aw. Sweet waitress.
Mission accomplished. The key and the directions.
My hero. I got some flashlights, just in case.
Hey, wait! Mrs. Wake! Your keys!
That diner was a real nut house.
Can you believe this place? This would make a wonderful setting for a book.
We're supposed to be on vacation, Alice. I'll figure it out when we get back home. Okay?
Okay. We can talk about this later.
Batman here on PBFF.
I didn't want to talk about it. I wanted to bury my head in sand.
Here's another one of my favorites to go with it.
Once upon a time, I was a successful writer, but that was a long time ago. I hadn't been able to write a word in 2 years, not since my last book.
I feel like that happens to the best of writers, though. And that's where things go horribly wrong. Diver's Isle.
Wow. It's gorgeous, Alan.
It's something, all right. Don't worry, honey. I'll get you inside safe and sound before it gets dark. And I've got the flashlight.
I know. I'm okay.
Alice had a phobia. The fear of darkness. I wanted to make sure we were inside with the lights on before sunset.
Oh, that's really sweet. See, they are sweet. I think that Alan's, like, insecurities are kind of getting to him, and that's why he's being, like, not rude, just, like, kind of dismissive of people, because they're like, he's like, not as good as you say. I know the mission is to get into the cabin, but I'm sure that this is not the right way to go. I'm not seeing anything to explore, so I should go to the right way. I keep trying to think that these are, like, God of War controls. It's going to take me a while to get used to these. So there's the creepy well, there's a winding path upward, the golden sun on the horizon, he's afraid of the dark, poor baby, cool raven, more cool ravens, hi, ah, sweet, look at all the ravens, hey friends, they're like, fuck off, Alan Wake. Bird Leg Cabin. This is probably the wrong cabin. There are already terrible things afoot here. I'm just exploring the area, seeing if there's anything to grab. Any additional thermoses, you know, just lying around. Okay, so there's also here. Oh, that's beautiful. Hold on. One second, I'm going to take a cinematic pan. These are always really helpful if I do decide to make a video, because then I do all the grunt work while I'm playing. So I will just take that video clip super quick, resume. A Murder of Crows doc on PBS is a good watch. Thank you for the recommendation there. I love corvids. I love them. Crows and ravens are just lovely. They were my late mom's favorite type of bird as well. She loved crows and she loved ravens.
An old generator had been connected to the power cable.
I found this by accident. Dun 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 dun. Well, you know how old motors work. Grung dun dun dun. All right. That's not gonna last. This place is gonna be plunged into darkness in no time. You know what works better than flashlights, in my opinion? Candles.
I'll freshen up a bit and start settling in.
Okay, I'll look around a bit.
Agreed, Inspector. Yeah, they did remaster it. So it could be a new coat of paint.
It was a beautiful place. I told myself I could rest here, sleep here, and forget about my work. I thought we could be happy here.
Return to Alice. Oh, wait, wait. There was something I was going to observe. It was a stump. Do-do-do.
Alice had told me about Cauldron Lake Lodge. The old building used to be a hotel, but these days it was no longer open to the public.
A small Yharnam lamp. That thing had infinite light. It really did. Perhaps it was a gas lamp. Yeah, candles are better. I live in a place that's heavy on hurricanes, and I had to stay at a friend's house when Irma came because, like, it came right over us. And they had flashlights that went out in the middle of the night because we had lost power. And I was like, I brought enough candles to light up a monastery, so they worked better. They worked all night and all day the next day.
The island had once been the site for a love story. Maybe it would be that again.
Let's see. TZ and BT. Interesting. Taking a screenshot of that for posterity. Oh, it's getting dark. Have you ever filled a gallon of water and shined a flashlight to the side? I don't know. I can't say that I have, Michael. What does it do? Does it project light everywhere, like diffused light? It'd be like a bulb like that.
Alice? Honey?
So there were kids here. Someone caught a delicious bass or got one from, like, Bass Pro Shops. Becomes a beacon. The beacons are lit.
A shoebox filled with books by Thomas Zane sat on the shelf. I'd never heard of him before.
He's, like, self-published and a rival of Alan Wake. I remember when you were doing exercises in the desert. That's really helpful that you were doing that.
The Deerfest guests have already started to arrive. Just ran into them. We'll see if we can rope them into an interview later on. Now let's go to the phones. Caller, you're on KBF FM.
Hi, Pat. It's Rose.
Why, hello, Rose. What's on your mind?
I know who that famous artist
is. Oh, no.
Wait,
what's
my favorite writer?
Well, Rose, I
just saw him at the diner. Oh, I am so excited he's here.
I'm sure he's glad to be here, too. Well, folks, I guess the secret's out. This is Pat Maine on KBF FM. Now, some music.
Great. So much for keeping a low profile.
Helps you see all the scorpions. Oh, my God. Yeah, I'm sure. If anyone doesn't know, Michael is a Marine, so... Freaking cool.
Alan, come here, Slowpoke. I'm waiting.
I was busy investigating absolutely every single corner, Alice.
Well, hello there.
Oh, hi.
A surprise. It's in the study. Go take a look.
Okay.
No, you're right here, Alice. But Alice, the surprise can wait. Where is the study? Where is the study? Is it here? Oh!
Surprise.
An old typewriter!
Alice? What is this?
I guess I have a small confession to make. I thought maybe you could write here, that a change of scenery would get you past...
Damn, Alice, you... Everyone
keeps... Hey, just hear me out! There's a local doctor, Dr. Hartman. I read a book of his. He has a private clinic here. He specializes in helping artists.
Maybe... So now you want to get me committed?
No, it's not like that. That's not... Alan?
Alan?
I don't. Just don't. I don't want to hear it. God damn it, Alice.
Aw, that sucks.
I knew she wouldn't follow me in the dark. I needed some time alone to think things through.
Yeah, she's on the phone. The lights are gonna go out.
Damn it.
Yep.
Alice?
Who called it?
The cabin had gone dark. All the lights were out.
Alan! Alan! Where are you? Help!
Oh
no!
No! I'd like to report a murder of crows.
From one nightmare and entered another. I couldn't remember how I got there. All I knew was that something terrible had happened to Alice. The phone was dead. I'd have to find help on foot.
No, Shadow Bullets, I don't think I will. That's only to be sassy. Is there anything here that I can grab?
Among Alice's things was a book, The Creator's Dilemma. I had Dr. Emil Hartman. Seeing the book brought back my fight with Alice. I didn't like it, and I didn't like the guy's smug face on the cover either.
Didn't like his smug face. He's just, honestly, a lot of that's just insecurity, I bet. He's insecure that he hasn't finished a book in 2 years. Ooh, shit, am I gonna die? Oh, yep! Ah, whoops. Alright, so I need to actually go down the path and not, you know, the opposite direction of the path. Oh, yeah.
Among Alice's things was a book, The Creator's Dilemma, by a Dr. Emil Hartman. Seeing the book brought back my fight with Alice. I didn't like it, and I didn't like the guy's smug face on the cover either.
Writer's block murdered Jack Torrance. I've never heard of that.
The gas station was my best bet. They'd have a phone I could use. It looked like a long hike through the forest to get there.
Of course. I was just reading a post about how gas stations at night are like the scariest things. And truly they are. I have a story. I was driving from New York City to Montreal a few years ago before the pandemic. And I needed to stop for gas, and there was only, like, there had been no gas stations for miles and miles and miles, and I found one. Shit! Well, there goes that author's smug face, right? But I found one in upstate New York, and it was, like, the only one in, like, for miles, and I came there, and it was the only thing that was lit, and it was the middle of the woods, and I was, like, horrified. I was like, I need to get the fuck out of here. I'm pumping my gas and running in the opposite direction. You may die occasionally, but definitely keep exploring. There's plenty of stuff off the beaten path. Cool. That's really good to hear. Writer's block caused The Shining. That's true. I like his story of how he created Carrie. He just took a lot of cocaine and locked himself in a room for 3 days, and then Carrie came out. It's one of my favorite, like, just book stories. Like, you're crazy, Stephen. Love ya. Love ya, Stephen King. I'm glad you're doing better now than you were in the old 70s.
Hello? Is someone there?
The loose sheets of paper were pages from a manuscript entitled Departure. That was the name I planned to use for the next novel I had never gotten started. I was named the author. I hadn't written it. I couldn't remember writing it. In the scene on the page, the hero was attacked by an axe murderer in the woods at night.
It's worse when there's a pump attendant at the gas station. Yeah, mine was like, there was no one around. It was closed. I looked at pictures of it during the day, and it was, like, not as bad. Like, it was a kitschy place with, like, a beaver, and it was like, get the fever with the beaver, and I was like, ah! And then, like, imagine the attendant really, like, hands it up and is like, welcome, welcome. Unleaded or super. I'm going way off the path. I'm gonna get stuck. Now I'm lost. I forgot where I was going. Oh boy. Oh shit!
Anybody there? Please, I've been in an accident.
Ah! Dude in the coat pops up to fill up your tank. That's hilarious. So I need to get to the gas station. Therefore I need to go down the hill. Okay. Logic. Mind if I keep popping my limbs? So if you hear a pop, it's probably my shoulder. Or my hamster. I don't know. Is the axe? I wonder if this is like he has amnesia or something and he's reliving his memories or like. Maybe he's suffering from a condition like Alzheimer's and he's like reliving his old memories, but he doesn't know what's real and what isn't because he's a horror writer. I'm gonna just file that theory away for later. Maybe I'm right, maybe I'm wrong. But like, ah, so good. And I'm like, I'm glad I don't know. Am I going back? I don't know where I'm going. My fault for going off the path. I mean, yeah, I don't think you could climb down unless you're, like, an expert rock climby type. Oh, yeah, so I have to go up to go down. All right. I keep thinking this is God of War. And I keep pressing the left control stick, and I'm like, why isn't he sprinting? You wonder what, like, reality he's in, or if he's even in reality. So I need to go up to go down. I need to just trust my instincts as I was wrong and I am lost. We will see. Checkpoint reached. Okay, I was going the right way.
The lights up ahead were a good sign. Maybe I wouldn't have to hike all the way down to the gas station to find a phone.
It's back in 2010 or so. It was a little harder to find reception. I love the fashions in this game because it just reminds me of that time, like with the long boots and the leather jackets. Like, oh, that's peak. That's timeless, I say. Timeless! Anything to, like, inspect? Let's take a look. So, hazardous environment, logging company. I kind of like them. I have a shirt that has leather elbow pads. Well, they're like pleather, but because they're washing machine friendly. But they're nice. They're very Ralph Lauren. I like Ralph Lauren because I like to look like I can afford to ride a horse. Or own a boat. That's the aesthetic that I like to go for. Like, you know, maybe I can look like I can afford to do these rich people things. Oh, well, why don't I go into this protected caution area? This seems like a very smart idea. Oh boy, what is jump? What is jump? Now I'm stuck in the extremely dangerous area.
I'm in an accident.
Do your ninja warrior thing, Alan Wake. He's a writer. He can't do it. He's not an athlete. Wait, can I operate the crane? Maybe operating heavy machinery after extreme trauma like this maybe isn't the best idea. Yeah, definitely Final Destination vibes, all the logs. Oh no. I'm in danger.
Hey, you!
Phil!
There's been an accident. I need help.
Deposit. Listen,
I need to...
Premium cabins for rent in...
Whitefall. Oh, hell.
Carl Stuckey.
Pleased
to meet you. Non-refundable
reservation
deposit required. Fair and square.
Maybe they didn't see him.
Fair and square.
You gotta be dumb, you gotta be tough. That is a motto for life. Oh no! Oh no, this is not good. Oh no, no. Pick up manuscript page. Can I read it? Hold on. Manuscript! Episode 1, Nightmare. The title page.
By Alan Wake.
Oh, wait.
Departure by Alan Wake.
Ah! This is total Final Destination vibes. Nope, nope, nope. To the no. With a side of no. Come on, use your American Ninja Warrior practice, Alan Wake. Hold on, scary dude. It's time to read. That's not how I am. I'm like, hold on. Oh, wait. Did I? God damn it. Oh, god damn it. I restarted. Oh, well. So, we're gonna let this fall. Hold on. Oh! Wake attacked by a shadowy murderer.
He turned to face me. His face was covered in shadows. It was hard to make him out in the darkness of the forest that surrounded us. But the axe he lifted was plain to see. It glistened with the blood of his victim. He grinned madly. The shadows were alive, distorting his features. It was a scene from a nightmare, but I was awake.
Were you, Alan? Were you awake?
The Taken stood before me. It was impossible to focus on it, as if it stood in a blind spot caused by a brain tumor and eye disease. It was bleeding shadows like ink underwater, like a cloud of blood from a shark bite. I was terrified. I squeezed the flashlight like my life depended on it, willing it to stop coming any closer. Suddenly something gave, and the light seemed to shine brighter.
All right, so we got these missing pages. Oh, so we got lore. We're gonna collect some lore. Oh, I'm excited. People know I love lore. He sure does. Like a blah, and a blah. It was like a blah. Oh, shit. I feel like this is a dream, and he's gonna wake up in the water. Ah! Hold on. What are my controls? Like, how do I get again to the... Oh, no. I need, like, a guide. Oh, so it was L1. Nice! Float like a butterfly, sting like a bee!
I had to figure a way out of this. Any second now, and Stucky would be knocking on the door with his axe like Nicholson in The Shining.
Parkour Shadow Lumberjack! Oh, pick up batteries, for sure.
It's the latest.
Pick up fashion.
In
Pick up a revolver. Yes.
Let you shoot.
Use the phone.
Yes. You can see the
sun. Great fall, Sheriff Station.
Hello? Hello?
Oh, he's coming in. Oh! Oh, McShits! Oh, noses! Okay, can I go through the window? Through the wall! Yes! Or not! Oh, I died! Oh, Lord, he coming! Through the window! Through the wall! Oh, wait. Did I pick up things? Oh, we need all the batteries. Until the sweat drips down my brow.
Yes.
Bright Falls Sheriff Station.
Hello? Hello?
And keep those cholesterol levels.
Nope. Uh-oh. How about here? Can I go here? And all these females bow? What? Oh, this is going to be complicated. It's going to take me a while to figure this out. Okay. But first, let me collect everything. All right.
Incontestably.
Yes.
Reuben.
Bright Falls Sheriff Station. How may I?
Hello?
Oh, skeet skeet shooting? Ah, no! This is where I die every time! Oh, no. Where do I go? I'm gonna go down a cliff. Okay, go. Checkpoint reached. Reach the gas station. Ah, where's the gas station? Oh, electrocution, right here, okay. Maybe I can lead the guy over to, oh wait.
The bulldozer had gone over the cliff at the office. I hoped Stucky had suffered the same fate, but I wasn't planning on staying to find out.
No, murderer is definitely alive. You're gonna like end up being the lone survivor character, Alan Wake. Why have a staircase to nowhere? Okay, let's go. A lot of electrical things. There's gonna be. Shit!
I am out with a concussion. I'd never fired a gun outside a shooting range, and now I just killed someone, or something. There were no bodies. They just disappeared. If I was dreaming, it felt real enough to make me sick.
Any loot here? Any loot? Anything? Pages?
The Dark Forest was the last place I wanted to go, but I had no choice. I had to get to the gas station.
Hold on, let me look for stuff. I don't know why I'm whispering. Revolver ammo. Yeah, we need batteries. We need batteries. Follow the yellow. Okay, that's a good idea. Alright, Oh, he's breathing. Yeah, he's probably asleep.
Hand-painted graffiti was revealed by my flashlight. Someone had hidden a chest of supplies near it.
Flare gun. Mm-hmm. Cool. Yeah, he's sleeping deeply. There's some green over here. Let's investigate. Oh yeah, that was supposed to like indicate the arrows, but I'm just like, nah. seeing the darkness is something I'm good at. As I see nothing in, like, 5 seconds and prove myself to, like, lie. Oh! Nice, nice. Pick up all the ammo. I see things in the distance. I see something shiny. Oh, manuscript page. This book is just gonna write itself. With very little effort, all you have to do is dodge the murderers. So easy, right? Right? I know I'm not gonna find all the pages, and this makes me sad preemptively. That's a trap. That lady.
What the hell was that?
The lady.
When I saw the river below, something uncoiled itself inside my head. I realized that I'd have to find a way across. I didn't even want to look at the water.
You afraid of water, Alan? I say this and it's probably, like, really cold. It can probably kill you within, like, minutes. I'm like, you afraid of a little water? My dumb ass. Can't be afraid of a little water, Alan Wake. So there are a couple ways it looks like. There's across that log. There's across this log here. I'm gonna see what's up here, even though it definitely looks like a dead end. Probably not the best thing way to go in a spooky game, but coffee! Neat. How do I drink the coffee? Like, can I have it? Can I has? At this moment? May I please? They like first you sit on a rock and you're just like, aren't murderers somewhere else? Turn off the light. Murderer can't see me. I am the darkness. Who's afraid of a little darkness? Oh yeah, Alice. Whoops. Sorry, Alice. What? Alas, indeed. That murderer is coming.
Stucky was still out there, in the dark, stalking me.
Stucky, don't you realize that this is the woods? This is no place for murdering innocent people, even though, like, every like, cabin in the woods story is like... Yeah, it's exactly the place where people murder people. Pick up lithium batteries, absolutely. Pick up revolver ammo, 100%. Pick up lovely IKEA furniture. Yes. He's like dragging IKEA furniture behind him, like, and a coffin for Stucky. Sorry, Stucky. Checkpoint reached. Oh, this looks, oh, mixed shit. Insert fucking battery. He has sickles! I could've used the flare, I bet, but I didn't feel like it. I have 34 bullets. Controls are like, sometimes suffer, but I think that's just because the game was an older one. So I forgive it. Alright, so there's these final destination logs. And then, oh, what do we got here? Yellow. Yellow, yellow, yellow. Follow the yellow. Oh, this is a great, great location. Yeah, he's asleep. Hmm. Is there anything here? There is a pathway, it looks like. Let's follow it. Oh!
Taken. They're taken.
The Taken are filled with darkness! Oh no, and his wife was taken! He, like, calls the Taken on the phone, and he's like Liam Neeson. He's like, I have a set of skills. A set of skills that can make me a nightmare for people like you. Let me just burn this place down for fun. Wait. It's yellow here. This looks like the perfect hiding place for a murderer! Alright! And a lovely stove and some furniture. Neat. Nice, so I'm stacked at the moment. I look like I need to be. There's murderers out here, undead ones. Back to the logs. Back to this extremely safe looking location. You're fighting the urge to make a nightmare Alan Wake fun. Do it! I'm here for bad puns. Like, please, let's have a pun off. I welcome it always. Yeah, it's funny, because in my community post, if you look, it says, like, evil Alan Wake be like, Alan sleep. Okay, we got more yellow. Yeah, that was just to say to go over there. There are some tracks. Alan ought to get woke. That's no way to treat his wife! Alan woke. Does he even climb that in real life? He hasn't been in the woods nearly enough in his life. I'm sorry, but as somebody who grew up in the woods, you know how to get into forbidden places sometimes. Alright, Alan Wake. Let's go. That is very precarious. That is a precarious thing. The darkness caught Alan napping. I already went there. So, let's see. There's another way. There's gotta be. Unless I completely missed it. We'll see. Something up there. Is that the gas station?
The staircase was broken. I had to make my way up some other way.
If he was a ninja warrior, he could make it up that easy. Or Caitlin Ohashi, famous gymnast.
I couldn't stay. There had to be a way to get up there.
Limit reached! Of all the ammo. Listen, I need more ammo!
There was no power. There was bound to be a generator somewhere at the logging site.
Jenny looks like it's over there. Let's go to the Jenny. Put down the power! Alright, so I can go up there. I feel like there's gonna be some kind of murder activity. Let's investigate anyway. Gotta be a reason why I can do this.
With all this forestry equipment around, there had to be something I could use to reach the top.
Well, I found what looks like the Jenny, so I'm gonna go get it. This would be a great time for coffee, if only I could have it. All right, hold on. I love the flare. Look at that! That's so funny to me. That's funny. That shouldn't be funny. But it is. That's hilarious. Start the Jenny. Oh, shit. Bring da ding ding ding. Bring da ding ding ding. Alright. Turned it on. Speaking of growing up in the woods, remember there was like a half mile of woods separating my childhood home and the local cemetery? Yeah! Now there's less than a half mile. Sorry to get dark, but my mom's buried like behind where I used to live. local cemetery is now, like, if you go down the street, like, if you take, like, a left, if you go out of your old home and take a left, cemetery is, like, not even a quarter mile. The new one. Even though it's not that, not that new anymore. New as of, like, 15 years ago. Yeah, there's a new one. And there's a historic, for people who didn't know, we lived in, like, an old historic town in Massachusetts. I know Eris from a long time ago. Oh, I got a shotgun! Oh my god, this is gonna be fun. Yeah, and we have, like, a historic cemetery near, like, an old-ass church. It's a very sleepy old town, which is why, like, places like this don't really scare me. We're like, oh no, cabin in the woods, so scary. And I'm like, ah, yeah. What's this? Oh no, am I gonna get murdered? Oh wait, no, I can't fit. Yeah, tombstones looks really cool. There are some really cool historical ones in Salem, and they say how the person was deceased, which is really cool. Like, sometimes they're sad, sometimes it's just informative, like, to tell, it really tells the story of these people. Hey, Sean. Grew up in my parents' house, it's right next to a cemetery. Wander around at night all the time. Me too. My hooligan friends and I, we used to like take like midnight walks, and we'd go through all the cemeteries because like it was the easiest thing to do. Ooh, coffee. I mean, cemeteries are supposed to be peaceful places, and normally, like a lot of time, they are. I used to kind of just go there to like hang out, to be honest. Collect your thoughts, because it's not a place where people really fuck around. Oh, move the lift. All right. This is gonna get interrupted by murderers. If I know my shit enough. All right. This looks about right. You would lose your little brother. Would you guys play, like, hide and seek there? That would be a place to play. Let's see, is this the one? Let's find out. There are two of them. Let's see, before I get attacked by murderers. Hydrate. All right. Is there anything here? I know I could go back for more supplies, but I think I'm okay. I didn't use any ammo. Oh, I'm gonna use the shotgun. That's funny. You'll jump out and scare him? Oh no. My sister knows if she tried to do that, it wouldn't scare me. That's the problem. She's like, yeah, I stopped fucking with you eventually because you stopped being scared. I'm like, yeah. I say as like 5 seconds from now, I like freak out over some murder. Oh, more yellow. Oh, we got a radio. The light, go into the light.
I was just outside for a breath of fresh air, and what a night. I know most of you are probably in your beds by now, but if you're still up and around, take a moment. Step outside for a spell and breathe in deep. The weather is absolutely still. The sky is crystal clear. It's like the forest is quietly breathing along with you.
Yeah, you can't hear breathing.
I'm a night owl, and it's on nights like this I wish I wasn't cooped up in the studio. Makes an old man like me wish I could just roam wild. But here I am, and who'd keep you company all night long if I weren't? It looks like I'm not the only one staying up late. Caller, you're on the air.
Hey, Pat, it's Maurice Horton.
Hello, Maurice. What are you up to?
Well, I was just taking Toby on his walkies.
Oh, isn't it beautiful out there?
Sure, but Pat, the reason I called is that Toby heard something rumbling in the undergrowth and took off after it.
Probably a rabbit.
Sure. Toby loves rabbits.
Well, sure.
Anyway, I figured that, you know, if anyone runs into Toby, they could grab him. My number's on his collar.
And Toby's a friendly dog?
Toby loves people. Usually he comes back, but we were pretty far from home, and it sounds like he went pretty wild there. Great dog, but he's just too dumb for his own good.
Well, Maurice, it's out there now. Hope Toby comes home soon. You have a good night now.
We're gonna find some fucked up version of that dog in this nightmare. So there's some sort of yellow over there. Okay, I'm gonna follow these signs. Usually there's a treasure trove. Treasure trove. Oh, there we go. Cool. I'm gonna use the shotgun because it seems like the most just funny. And where's they play the freakiest music right now? This is the thing about being a night owl. Don't tell people that you're working with that you're a night owl, or else they'll never, like, they'll have you working at night. You're like, no. The nighttime is me time. It's time for reflection. Hell yeah, it's taking me back there. It's like the sheriff in the first season of Stranger Things when he goes, "The morning is for coffee and contemplation." I'm like, I live by that, for sure. Oh, manuscript. Hold on. Let's read. Manuscript. Episode 1, Nightmare. Wake fights with a Taken with light. Yeah, I'm already missing a page.
The Taken stood before me. It was impossible to focus on it, as if it stood in a blind spot caused by a brain tumor and eye disease. It was bleeding shadows like ink underwater, like a cloud of blood from a shark bite. I was terrified. I squeezed the flashlight like my life depended on it, willing it to stop coming any closer. Suddenly something gave, and the light seemed to shine brighter. I heard them before I saw them, swooping down from the sky and screeching as they came. I spun around just as the cloud was upon me. For an instant, I stared into 100 dead eyes, black pearls glittering in the darkness. I raised the flashlight and the swarm exploded like fireworks. Feathers burned, turned into ash. I couldn't hear my scream above theirs.
Aw, oh, poor little ravens.
At first I kept finding the pages as if by accident. The book I couldn't remember was either a terrible and true prophecy or an act of creation that had rewritten the world. I began to hunt the pages feverishly, for they held the answer to the mystery. With it, I could save myself. With it, I could save Alice. Rose knew she had been gushing, but right now, she didn't care. As far as she was concerned, her brief meeting with Alan Wake was literally the high point of her life. She watched as he got in the car with his wife. She was pretty, confident, at ease with Wake. Not like Rose. They were perfect for each other. She'd have given anything to be called their friend.
He obviously doesn't like Rose much. Who knows? I want to give her the benefit of the doubt, but this is like a thriller game, so... Crazy fans. In a horror game.
The gas station was closer now. Its light welcoming in the darkness.
He has the dog. No, he has the puppy! Gotta rescue the puppy. And Alan's like revealing exactly where he is with this flashlight. Foolish. Gotta slink into the darkness, Alan. Don't you know anything about sneaking around? Alright. This is me going backward. I think. Let's see. Okay, let's see. Nope, I'm in exploration mode, not hunting murderer mode. Oh yeah, murderers are coming. Look at the fog! Hold on. Oh shit. Ah! Sorry, I find that hilarious. I probably wasted flares doing that, but worth it because it's funny. All right. Oh my god. Oh no! Oh god. Whoa! Okay, maybe the shotgun wasn't the best idea. Alright, let me get the right the fuck out of here right now. Anything to find? Doesn't look like it. Oh, there are books here, there are books. Pick up batteries, pick up ammo. This is an inordinate amount of murders. Alright. Got it working. So I think I can restore my health here. It's getting very suspenseful. Alright, let's go out into the night. Ooh, hi there, murderer. Alright, we need to get to this gas station. This has been an ordeal. Oh, there's a page over there. Ah! No, no. Stranger danger! Alright, Alan. At least it gives you plenty of supplies. I feel like this is going backward. That's what it feels like, but I could be wrong. No, nope, nope, that is a cliff. Oh, maybe where I was going was correct. Yeah, going backward, I think. Yes, Alan, go deeper into the woods. That's a great idea. This is the point where I'd be like singing random ass lullabies, because like, when else would you do? Nope. Alright, I'm back here. Alright, I need to find where I was a second ago. Oh, coffee. Ugh. Bad time to get lost in the woods. Nope. This has you going uphill. Yeah, he seems a little too tired to keep him sprinting. All right. Is this new? No, I've been here. I have been here. Oh, wait, this is where I was, though. Okay, this is where I was. Yes, this is where I need to be. We got the yellow. He's just raving right now, this guy. Treasure trove. I don't want to just like shoot my flare into that and like maybe I can bust it up. That didn't work. It was worth a try, though. Where go? Maybe downhill? I definitely heard him down here, so I gotta be prepared for a fight. Caution, proceed at your own risk, logging area ahead. Yeah, for sure at my own risk. Manuscript page up ahead. Oh, the power. I'm a simple person. Sometimes I just love big explosions. Supplies. Lithium batteries. Shotgun ammo. And where is he keeping all these shotguns?
Science. It bestows immortality on those who advance it to elevate all of mankind. Newton, Einstein, Sagan, princes among men. But the price for such a legacy is steep indeed. Springs. Tonight's episode, a quantum suicide. If our lives are already written, it would take a courageous man to change the script. Having called a press conference, Dr. Barclay Colvin is about to demonstrate that very courage.
Ladies and gentlemen of the press, I am Dr. Barclay Colvin. And I'm glad so many of you could join me here at the Moorcock Institute. Tonight, I'm
Moorcock Institute.
Demonstration of the many worlds.
Sorry, I'm five.
As you can see, this is a loaded 9mm pistol. It shall be part of a thought experiment.
That guy's like, I do not trust the white man with the 9mm pistol.
Known as a quantum suicide.
Did he say suicide? Is that a real gun? He's kidding, right?
Please, stay calm. There is no risk.
I am not fine. What occurred? I am not. No! Sir!
Forehead. Now, you might think this round is merely a dud. Not so. Observe the flower pot. And yet, I myself cannot be harmed with this gun.
You sure, buddy?
Pull of the trigger, two new realities branch off. One in which the weapon didn't fire, and one where it did.
It's like Schrodinger's cat.
Machine here, I have ensured that this reality is always the former. I have bestowed upon myself quantum immortality. Under no circumstances can this gun kill me.
Don't know about that, sir.
Every time you pull the trigger, in another reality, you die?
Yes, yes, of course, but that's completely trivial. There's an infinite number of things that could happen at any moment, and they always do happen somewhere. The point is, this one thing did not happen here.
The plug got pulled!
Insane! Insane!
Hey, was this thing supposed to be plugged in? I stumbled on it.
You fools!
You fools!
Gaze upon quantum immortality!
What? The splatter sound!
Poor, poor Dr. Colvin. Filled by his own hubris or the ignorance of the masses. Perhaps he should have left the crate unopened, the decaying atom unobserved.
Perhaps he shouldn't have tried to shoot himself! Night Springs, yo. Oh my god. So this is like suggesting that Alan Wake lives in two different realities. One is kind of like the dream state, which is where I am at now, which seems to really be the setting of one of his books. And then the other is like the real dream state where the wife went missing. Was that an actual episode of The Twilight Zone? Maybe? Maybe. I feel like you or my dad would know better. My dad loved Twilight Zone. He refers to it a lot. I haven't seen it since I was little. He's like, yeah, it's like the one episode of The Twilight Zone where, and it's like, you know so many things. Oh, they are swinging! They are swinging! I wonder if I can shoot it at the top and, like, kill some murderers with some logs. An homage to The Twilight Zone. Oh, this looks most precarious. This looks like a health hazard waiting to happen. Hey, but I got loot. Oh, he's here. He's here somewhere. The dog might be here too. I'm concerned. I am heckin' concerned about this dog. Oh, yeah, he's like right in front of me, isn't he? I always do the Sekiro thing. I call it the Sekiro thing when I'm like hiding and then I'm like physically just like looking over. I'd kind of stick out here with my Cthulhu dress. Be an unwise choice of clothing with a murderer chasing me, you know. Wait. Sorry. Too funny. Oh, shit. Nice! Nordic walking is the trophy I got.
Leaving behind only a lifetime of nightmares to come. Assuming I'd reach the lights at the gas station alive.
Well, we got more coffee. There's so much coffee to drink. Drink it before it goes bad, friend. Notice my swinging logs, Senpai Alan! Alan Senpai, notice me! The Nordic track. Speaking of, I finally got up the courage to go back to my, to the gym. I mean, I do some sort of activity 6 to 7 days a week, but, like, you can tell I've been missing out on my low-impact cardio, for sure. So I went, I sucked it up and I wore a mask, and it was hard. It was, like, I would say, like, 3 times harder than going and not wearing a mask, but I did it, and I promised myself to do that at least once a week. I try to go when the place is pretty much empty. I'm still pretty fearful of going, like, indoors around people. Definitely mask when I do it. But I'm happy. I feel like it's going to be better for me if I keep doing it. Because I don't know, like, I'm pre-pandemic, I was a gym rat. So this has been hard on me. Even though, like, today was leg day. Even though I ate like crap, today was still leg day. Did arm day early last week, so I'm going to do arm day again, like, tomorrow or the next.
I recognized the parade float I had seen in Bright Falls when I first arrived with Alice.
Deerfest! Oh, gas station's right there. Alan Wake Senpai, notice me. That's like everybody at this town. Alan Wake Senpai.
After the insanity I had just experienced in the darkness, the lights of the gas station felt comforting. At least for a moment, the sane world reasserted itself.
Yeah, those are the best places when you're in like a scary game and you get to a safe place. Greatest feeling. I think it was a Cull Obsidian who came very briefly in the last stream, but I felt bad because he was right before the big spoiler God of War, and I was like, don't proceed if you don't want to be spoiled. But he, I think he was the one who recommended a whole playlist of like safe spaces and horror games, and I love that.
The Deer Fest had been 2 weeks away when we arrived.
7 days!
I was missing a whole week between the night we got here and now.
Whoa. But it's like, I haven't played a lot of Silent Hill or Resident Evil, but...
someone had trashed the place, or that there'd been some kind of fight.
Oh, yeah, I see that. But, I love, like, the music that you get in those safe spaces, like Bloodborne.
I'll keep writing. Outside, there's only darkness. Outside the cabin, outside the story, there's only darkness. I can feel her presence in the dark. Just now, I could smell her perfume in the room. I'll reach her, I'll fix it up. I'll bring her back. The story will come true. If I stop, she's lost.
I don't believe this.
The story coming true.
On the TV, talking crazy. Was I losing my mind?
Nordic walking. You guys were right. Rose did have a full-size cutout. That's true. And, like, he's making Rose out to seem kind of suspicious. The 68th Annual Deer Fest, September 15th to the 18th. Games and activities, raffle tickets, fishing competition, pie contests, and surprise competitions. Live music for the children. Bucktooth Charlie, afternoons, and Montgomery, the Mystic's Amazing Phantasmagoria, evenings. Don't miss the legendary Deer Fest Parade. That's going to be some sort of a culmination is Deer Fest. Oh, speaking of, I don't know. For some reason, this reminded me of RPGs. But Eris, if you're still here, welcome. I got the Keeper's Handbook of Call of Cthulhu. So if we're ever like, hey, I don't want to do the campaign for a couple months, I could do a Call of Cthulhu campaign. I want to do like a one-shot story or like one shot, which will probably be like three separate sessions. But like, I'm excited. That was a birthday gift from, I believe, my dad. But I'm super, super excited. Because I've been getting into Call of Cthulhu. Yes! Oh, I'm so excited! Yeah, I would just want it to be like a short little, like, if we say if we finish our campaign, or if you want to take a break for a couple months, like, it'll be a little horrific, but, like, it'll be funny, because there'll be, like, tentacle monsters. So there's definitely some phantasmagoria going on. There's a mystic here. I think that's what reminded me of Call of Cthulhu, is, like, the mysticism. Yeah, I'm excited. I have a couple ideas for a campaign, and I want you guys to choose, like, the location and settings. I have a couple settings and locations cooking around in my mind, and then I want to craft, a quick, like, one-shot or two-shot story based on it, and just go. We totally need a break from our two... Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like, even if it's, like, a year from now. But I'm excited, like, the fact... So, Eris is one of my closest friends, also the DM... in our D&D campaign, which some of you know about. And, like, I'm so excited because she created a Halloween session that we're going to do next week. I'm super, super excited for that. I mean, Alan's here. He can steal all the candy he wants. Steal it, Alan. No one will see you. There are no cameras in here. It's a small town. Take everything. Aw. No, we're gonna go downstairs to the creepiest possible area. Oh, I can't go down there? Well, I mean, it's just to fix the car, but still. Oh, the phone. Meanwhile, I was like, steal candy! Take tankards of gasoline and throw them at murderers! Yes. I need the phone. Look at that phone! My family had a phone like that growing up.
Great Falls Sheriff Station.
Howdy, Sheriff.
Oh, thank you.
Thank God, Sheriff.
Sheriff Sarah Breaker, you are...
I'm Alan Wake, but listen, I was in a car crash. My wife, Alice, she's missing.
Calm down, Mr. Wake.
We were staying in a cabin on the island, on Cauldron Lake.
There's no island on Cauldron Lake, not since the big eruption in the 70s.
Please, I can take you there, okay?
You look like you've taken a pretty bad knock to the head. Are you okay?
Listen.
We'll figure this out. Please get in the car. We'll swing by the lake and then we'll go to the station, okay? Mr. Wake, have you seen Stucky, the guy who owns this place?
I realized I couldn't tell her what had happened in the forest. She wouldn't have believed me. And then she wouldn't have helped me with Alice.
I wonder if this is chapter one. Is this the same place or is this a different place? What? Oh!
Colored clown, they call the Sandman. Tiptoes to my room every night.
So I guess that's the beginning of the game.
Just a sprinkle stardust and a whisper. Go to sleep.
End of episode one. I wonder how many episodes there are. I would love for this to be a short game, to be honest. The end. Bye, everybody. That's it. That's the whole game. It never happened. The cabin in the woods doesn't exist. Is there more? Or are we just going to get a copyright strike for this music?
With my wife, Alice.
Thank you for coming here with me. I thought maybe you could write here.
I don't want to hear it. God damn it, Alice.
Now, she's missing.
Alice? Alice?
I woke up behind the wheel of a crashed car. I'm missing a week. I was attacked by shadowy men straight from a nightmare. The sheriff took me to the lake Alice and I had stayed at. But the cabin had disappeared.
Taken. And the Taken are what the murderers are called. New York City 3 years ago. Song here by Poe. I know we're marathoning it like it's Netflix.
Honey.
Maybe you are Alan Wake, Shadow Bullets.
Sweetie, how was it?
Worst weather I've ever seen.
You should put some coffee on. It'll warm you up.
Oh, my God, honey. You look so warm. Hold on. Let's take the thermos. I wonder what it means to take the thermos.
Hey, handsome. This is going to be a long night. So she must... shots are turning out great.
She must be a photographer.
You're going to need that coffee, then.
And she's taking his headshots. Oh, that's great. Oh, look at the murder stuff on her Photoshop. I still haven't seen Squid Game. I keep wanting to call it Squid Games, though. I want to so badly. We were like, okay, we'll stop and sleep after this episode. No, you can't. You won't. Because it'll just keep marathoning it. I started Midnight Mass, but I kind of struggle marathoning things now. I think my attention span isn't quite what it used to be. So I got through the hour, and then I was like, well, watch it another time. Oh my God, his apartment is beautiful. Are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? And it's a two-bedroom in New York? Alan Wake, your books must be doing pretty well. And then the end, we're like, oh no, I can't find the remote. Oh no. And then the next episode already started. That's funny.
Coffee's on.
Great, thanks.
If this is Boston, he'd be like, coffee's on. Yeah, I still haven't seen The Boys. Look at all them books. I like long to have a place that's big enough for me to have a lot of bookshelves. I finally bought myself a bookshelf and it's the greatest thing of all. And for my birthday, I asked for a bunch of books. I'll just, this is random, but I'm gonna show them. I like collector's books. So like, I mean, these are old. I'm gonna show you some old ones first. So I got Cthulhu Mythos Tales, you know, speaking of Call of Cthulhu. And, oh my god, these are my zines. My zines are popping out. Oh no. That's a Hades zine. I don't know why I'm showing this. I guess it's like the me going like a squirrel. I got Dracula, my special edition. And for my birthday, I got the Arabian Nights, which is so classic. It matches my dress, yes. And like, I love a lot of stories from Arabian Nights, so I'm very attached to them. And I have Uzumaki, and this book is like super going out of print really fast, but I also got for my birthday, Tomie. So I started Tomie, but I only got through like the first chapter. Ito's books are ones where I kind of get through really quickly. Boys is rough, entertaining, and also rough. Yeah, that can sometimes those can be hard to watch. Trying to hunt down the Silmarillion Leatherbound. I'm sure you'll find it somewhere. Oh, I have the OG trilogy. It's like a suede bound, but it's actually really hard in the hand, so I probably can't read it. I used to have like a cardboard hardcover, but I destroyed it reading it really vigorously. So I got the suede bound thinking, oh, I can read this again. Don't think I can, because the feeling of the suede on the hands after a while is no good. Probably have to go back to Alice, but look at all those books. Random aside, I am an average enjoyer of books. Also, very much collecting my Yu-Gi-Oh! Collection. I have almost the whole thing, except for two books that went out of print while I was collecting, so rude.
Oh,
I'm missing...
Hey, I just finished those cover mock-ups. They're on your desk. Tell me what you think.
I'm missing volumes like 4 and 5, I think.
You get them done this quickly.
On occasion, I can perform all sorts of miracles, my dear.
Oh, really?
Well, you seemed to think so last night.
Oh, Alice! Love her! How did you ever make her go missing, Alan? She's a treasure. She's a treasure. This is his office. So, 3-bedroom! Alan! You live very well. Oh, this is his books. Return to sender. But I can't forget Alex Casey. Alex Casey thriller. The things that I want in the fall of Casey. So Casey seems to be like his recurring character, not calendar. Wow. And he got his little double revolvers there. Oh, they probably are Alice's. Salmon.
These look really good.
Oh, sure, until Barry gets his hands on them. Which, by the way, will happen over my dead body. The last time was the last time. Oh, and speaking of Barry, he called.
Oh, shit.
Alan!
I'm over here, Alice.
Please check the fuse box.
Aw.
I'm right here. I'm on it, honey.
Please hurry.
I'm right here, baby.
I'm fine. Just
you're tempted to drop $200 on a handmade binding of the first edition of the Silmarillion. Wow, that's impressive. You know, Eris, I don't know. The QR code in the office. Like, I want to, like, put my phone to it. But Alice awaits! Okay.
Honey, it's a power outage. I've got the flashlight.
Okay.
Aw, Alice. You need candles.
Hi.
Candles are way better than the flashlight.
Okay? I'm sorry. It just really spooked me.
Don't worry. We'll just break out the candles.
Yes, agreed.
I know it's stupid, but it's just... Especially when I'm not prepared for it, you know? It gets to me.
I love you.
Tell me a story, Ryder.
Ooh! Okay.
I used to have these nightmares when I was a kid.
Where I was ripped open by tentacles.
When it got really bad, my mom gave me this old light switch. She called it the clicker.
The clicker, huh?
Yeah. If I ever got scared of the dark, I could just flip the switch and a magic light would scare the monsters away.
Oh, sure.
That's the plot of this game.
Alan.
Maybe it'll help you too.
Yeah, nice story, writer boy. You made that up right now, didn't you?
No. Seriously.
I love you. Even if you are a liar. Thanks for this.
They're so cute. Come on. They're adorable. You too. Oh, yes! Looks like everything else is super dark except for that one room, which has like so many candles. I love that. Bright Falls, the present day.
Hmm. How do you feel, Mr. Wick? Any nausea, disorientation, anything like that? Mr. Wick, how are you feeling?
Fine. Great.
I'm okay.
Never better.
I had to lie about my headache and memory loss. He'd send me to a hospital for tests. I couldn't leave without Alice.
Very well. I don't think you have a concussion, but you've obviously been through quite a shock.
He has a bath on his desk.
Thanks.
Where's he gonna go? His cabin's gone.
Well then, Mr. Wake, we're done here. If the pain gets any worse or you experience any other symptoms, you should come see me. I'll let you get on with it then.
He says this like dead ass fish.
Is waiting for you. She's very good at her job. I'm sure she can locate your wife in no time.
Doc Nelson was the image of a small town doctor. Sheriff Breaker had called him to the station to take a look at the cut in my head.
All right, we'll go see the sheriff. I'm going to go to about 2 hours or so. Reed. Missing, Richard Bow, Bruce Stansky, Jacob Miller. On a campaign trip, overdue, haven't been in contact. If you've seen them or know their whereabouts, please call 555-9932 and get a free CD. Thank you. Exit. Shouldn't have read exit, but...
Come in, Mr. Wake.
No.
Your phone's on the desk.
Your phone's on the desk. I want to, like, explore a little more. Have you seen this man? Disappeared. 6-2007. Identifying features. Knack for winning contests. That's not a feature! I mean, it is, but it's like metaphor. That's not physical. Like brown hair, 28 years old, you know? Missing the kitty! No, that's the one that makes me the saddest. Alan Wick. And he just like kills everybody.
The sheriff is waiting for you in her office down the corridor.
Nope, gonna sneak around the sheriff's office, thank you.
I guess you can call her the town eccentric. She used to be
a Mulligan here. But she's focused on other things these days. There's no sign of him. Over.
Wait. Yeah, this is Thornton. Look, we've located the brake float. It's here. That's some good news, right? Stucky was supposed to be driving it at the rehearsal today. Over.
Oh, give me that. Mulligan here. Looks like someone really thrashed the garage. Over.
Okay, roger that, guys. Keep looking for Stucky. Jane's out.
So the garage thing definitely happened. Stucky's missing. We have a town eccentric named Cynthia picking up this coffee. Picking up this page. Hold on. Let's take a look at the manuscript. Ooh, okay, so we got Nightmare. Wake lies to the sheriff. TV in the gas station.
I stepped into the gas station's garage. It was dark and quiet. The place was a mess. It looked like someone trashed the place or that there'd been some kind of fight. Light spilled into the room through an open door at the back, and I made my way toward it. Without any warning, I was blinded by a bright light. An old portable TV on the shelf had come alive by itself. Impossibly, I could see myself on the screen, talking like a madman.
So somebody's watching him.
The cabin on Cauldron Lake? She asked. The sheriff looked at me suspiciously. The early morning light flooded through the office windows. I would probably never have gotten out of the woods alive without her help. But I couldn't tell her the truth of what I'd faced the previous night. She'd think I was lying, or crazy. She'd lock me up, and she wouldn't help me find Alice. Stucky spat on the garage floor and tried to shake the cobwebs from his head. Ever since the couple never showed to pick up the keys, things had been fuzzy. Something, a feeling, caught his attention. Stucky looked up and stared as his brain tried in vain to process the horror before him. He stumbled back, knocking over a can of oil. A black pool spread across the floor while he struggled for a brief moment, then let go as the unrelenting darkness engulfed him.
Whoa.
Rose knew she had been gushing, but right now, she didn't care. As far as she was concerned, her brief...
Okay, we already read that one. All right, chapter 2, Taken.
It's true what they say about the fall and the sudden stop at the end. I'd lain here in the snow while the lurid chain of scenes that had led me here kept playing in my head. A rerun of my own private snuff movie. A memory of my corpse. Alone at my own wake. Thinking in metaphors again. The femme fatale was gone. Only a sour taste remained of the kiss that killed me.
Oh, I love that. Wait. This is like when Bailey Sirian, it was like, if you like true crime and murder, and she's like, oh shit.
This was a late goodbye.
I don't know who this is.
Years after I'd gotten my revenge, it had finally caught up with me. It had been a long time to bear the pain. My blood painted the snow red, a gruesome slushy, dissolved all the scattered painkillers and leisurely dripped down to the sewer, mingling with the bile of the city, becoming one with it. I can see them now, my wife and my baby. Honey, I'm home.
Is that Stucky? Oh, the different Takens. That's interesting. Alice sees a shadow.
Alice looked through the viewfinder, lining up the shot. Cauldron Lake was breathtaking. Something caught her eye. A figure standing in the shadows behind the cabin, like a thin woman in a black dress. She lowered the camera and looked again. No one there. Just a collection of bushes that looked vaguely human-shaped. She shook her head and laughed.
That's when she was taking photos. All right, so we got some lore. Now we're going to go see the sheriff.
The sheriff wants to see you in her office, Mr. Wake.
I love, like, the story of, like, the femme fatale with the poison kiss. Like, that's great. That's so good. Got the Jenny over here. What's in the closet? Like, they don't mind at all that I'm, like, snooping around the sheriff's office. All right, Ms. Sheriff Breaker.
Have you started looking for my wife yet?
My men are already on it. Now, can you tell me what happened?
I'm not sure. I can't remember. We were arguing. I walked out of the cabin.
The cabin on Cauldron Lake? How did you end up at Stucky's gas station?
I wanted to tell her what had happened last night, but I couldn't. She'd lock me up. Excuse me. I need to take this. Hello?
Alice, please help me.
Alice?
Stop talking to the law. You'll do exactly what I say if you ever want to see your wife again.
Who is this?
Go to the back lot.
Oh, shit.
Go on the fence on the left. Look inside the junker. I left a little something there to convince you we're all on the same page here.
That's a great song.
If you ditch the cops, you're going to meet me in Elderwood National Park. There's a spot called Lover's Peak. Midnight. Don't do nothing stupid, pal.
Be like, where the fuck is Lover's Peak?
I need some fresh air. Can I go out in the back, maybe?
Of course, Mr. Wake. I understand. You can get there through the cells. Deputy Grant can show you the way.
You're like, watch me
in
the back.
All of this, it's just a lot to take in.
Okay. Good thing I, really explored first. Wait, there's stuff in here. Isn't there? No, maybe not. Thought that was a shiny page. The man's gone. His fish is gone. Oh, there he is.
Mr. Wake, can I help you with anything?
I need to get some air. The sheriff said I could go out back.
Of course, Mr. Wake. You can get there through the cell corridor.
Hey, mister! Hey, can you turn the lights on? The deputies, they don't understand. They won't listen to me. I need it to be bright in here. Hey, you! Can you help me?
Maybe I can help. Hold on. I found a generator. I could tell the lady at the front. I don't know if it works this way, but I'm like... Oh, no, I can't do it. Well, I tried. And now I know it's there. Poor guy. Bye!
The early morning light hurt my eyes and made my head ache. The man on the phone had said, go through the fence on the left.
Well, folks, it's been another long night.
Oh, light switch?
It's about time for me to sign off. God knows I need my beauty sleep. Just one more item before I go. It's been a busy night for the sheriff's department. We've had a few broken windows, even a report of shots fired on Main Street. Deputies Mulligan and Thornton had to deal with two intoxicated young men who were celebrating the completion of their Deer Fest float. Now, folks, we get this every year. I know it's exciting, the big day is almost here, but let's save it for the party and leave the gunplay for the shooting competition, huh? There's no point in getting all worked up yet.
Okay. I'm gonna try that light switch. Let's try to make this guy happy. I feel like that might be good for later. Okay. Light switch.
Turn the lights on!
Meanwhile, I was like, bye, bitch!
Thank you, man. Thank you.
The caller had told me to find a hole in the fence behind the police station. There was something for me in an abandoned car.
Tell you different. You know, I shouldn't even be in here.
Oh, I see. They're all innocent. He's a little drunk, but hopefully they'll let him sleep it off. Alright, so I'm gonna do some spying. Alright, so doesn't seem like I can spy, but I'd be like... Yes, I know. Trying to spy on people, God. Oh, can I not go here? Maybe not. All right. There's got to be a way for me to get over there. Examine the junker. That's over there. Let's see, can I go through? No, this is back. This is back. This I couldn't open. This is a conundrum. What about these over nya? Oh wait, can I jump? I can. Oh. Hold on, we got important lore over here.
Alice's driver's license had been placed on the front seat.
Oh, creepy.
The caller meant business.
Barry?
You for a week, you and Alice. I've been worried sick. I flew out yesterday. I'm here in Bright Falls.
Barry, listen to me. I'm at the sheriff's station. Come and get me. I can't talk now.
Al, what the hell is going on?
I had to get the sheriff to let me go. I needed to get to Elderwood National Park to meet Alice's kidnappers.
The ladder up there. This is so good that I just want to keep playing, but I'm like, I should stop for the day. Alright, I'm gonna, like, get through whatever scene that... Oh!
The Rider is a light that reveals the world of his story from darkness, shapes it from nothingness. The way a sculptor carves a statue from a block of granite. If I stop, the world I'm making dies. Darkness will reclaim it. It's a long, hard journey into the dark. Alice's life is at stake, but I can't think about that, or I'll lose it. The dread lingers at the edge of perception. I'll push on. Anything is possible here. I'll write the story. I'll save her.
Interesting.
Marvelous, Sarah.
Marvelous.
I just wanted to settle all the damage the Anderson brothers might have inadvertently caused.
Are you feeling any better, Mr. Wake?
I'd like to leave. Am I free to go?
Well, we still need to talk about...
Am I under arrest?
No, of course not. But I need to know where you'll be staying so I can get in touch with you.
I'd avoid the motel. The Majestic is known for its roaches. The cabins in Elderwood are pretty nice, though.
That sounds perfect.
I'm Dr. Emil Hartman. I'd like to invite you to stay at Cauldron Lake Lodge.
Did you talk to my wife?
I had the pleasure of discussing your situation with her on several occasions.
Did you set something up with her?
I invited her here. My clinic is a place
He's the doctor! Oh, with a smug face!
move. Get your hands off of my client.
Who are you?
I'm Barry Wheeler, his agent. If you have business with Mr. Wake, you talk to me. You yokels won't know what hit you once I sick my lawyers on your asses.
No harm done, Sarah. I'm all right. I don't want to press charges. Mr. Wake, my offer still stands.
Get me out of here.
What the hell was that about, Al? We don't need a replay of that thing with the paparazzi. I thought they were gonna lock you up.
I had to talk to someone. I told Barry everything. He thought I was certifiable, but when he heard about the manuscript, I had him. The fact that I'd written something, even if I couldn't remember it, was enough for him. He smelled money. And he believed that Alice had been kidnapped. Anything beyond that was another story. I had a midnight appointment with the kidnapper in a place called Lover's Peak, somewhere in Elderwood National Park. The plan was to rent a cabin.
I don't like it, Al. I don't like any of it. It's not good. In fact, it's the absolute opposite of good.
Oh, the lady.
Barry, you found him.
Hi, Rose.
Oh, wow. I was just thinking about you, too.
Great.
I was just bringing Rusty some coffee. He's on the balcony, looking after Max. Poor thing. I really need to go. Great to see you again, Mr. Wake. Later.
Who's Max?
John Wick's cousin, Alan Wick.
What an airhead.
All right.
Please, mister, takes a swing at everybody. This is not her fault. She's a very nice girl and, more importantly, a fan.
All right. So I'm actually going to end it here since we've crossed about 2 hours, getting a bit later. But thank you guys for joining. This has been pretty exciting. Already on episode 2, and you know, by next week hopefully I will have looked up how many episodes there are, but I'm excited to unravel the mystery. Yeah, I hope you guys have a great rest of your Sunday, or if you're somewhere else, the great Monday and a great week ahead. Bye guys.